You cannot separate peace from freedom, because no one can be at peace unless he has his freedom. Malcolm X. We live in a society where the civil rights movement is seen as a thing of the past, a footnote in our textbooks, and a time in history that's seen as weakness rather than a fight for acceptance. How many people can you name from the civil rights movement other than Martin Luther King Jr., Malcolm X, or Rosa Parks? 5, 10, maybe 20 people, right? Tonight, I will give you an insight into the civil rights movement. Just one issue that right now seems to be an issue in my school, Central Riveras High School. By definition, the civil rights movement was a mass popular movement to secure for African Americans equal access and opportunities for the basic privileges and rights of U.S. citizenship. The civil rights movement began in 1954 and ended in 1968. Was that really when the problem started? In 1896, the Supreme Court case, Plessy versus Ferguson, justified segregation as saying that it was separate but equal in schools. Segregation is when they decided to separate students by their race, as in there was an all-black school and there was an all-white school. In 1954, the Supreme Court case Brown versus the Board of Education established that segregation of schools was unconstitutional. But how did it get brought up in the first place? A young girl by the name of Cheryl Brown was forced to attend an all-black school by riding the bus, rather than going to the all-white school that was just down the street from her home. This and four other cases was brought together to bring up to the Supreme Court, where they then said that it was unconstitutional due to the 14th Amendment that legalized equality in all races. Now, how does that tie into what's going on in my school right now? In the past few days, a young Caucasian female was recorded using a derogatory term that was used to inflict African Americans in hatred and with pain. In response, many of our students and staff have emailed the principal of our school and asked, hey, this is going on, what are you guys gonna do about it? Rather than enforcing the issue and saying this is not okay, they did say, if you do not delete any videos that you have and take them off of social media, you will be punished. So they shushed the issue rather than saying, hey, this is not okay. Is it okay? It's not okay. Then it did reach countywide. I live in Cabarrus County. Other students who believed that the girl who said it was okay decided to make their own videos using the word and saying that I can say it when I want and how I want to. Now, what is the definition of this word that they use? The definition of the word is a contemptuous name for a black or dark-skinned person. Now, not only is that the definition, it is an offensive noun. So whether they knew the definition of the word or not, it's an offensive noun that is used to hurt and target other people. Now, the school still has not done anything, but rather than letting the school wait for themselves, the African American community has bonded together to form their own club that is going to reach out and bring information as to what that word is and why it is not okay. Because we live in a society where it is not okay, and we will not let it sit. We cannot reach freedom if we don't have peace. And there will be no peace if they're using words that are meant to harm us because they decided they didn't want to use their own dictionary. So, that is all I have to say. Thank you, and I'm fine.